Welcome back, everybody. As per usual, I am Jansey, and as not so per usual, we are in a different world today, and we will be moving over to the other world in due course, but for now, I need to show you guys something. We need to have a little bit of a understanding here, because I'm going to be building a ship today. This will be part one of three, I imagine, and it is going to have to stand up to this kind of standard. And in fact, we're going to take the bar, we're going to move it just a little bit over. See one of these bars, these masts, you can take one of those, move it a little bit over. And that is where we're going to be for the future ship that we are starting today. But don't worry about that. We'll get to that in some time. What I want to do is for the people who are new to the channel, and of course you guys, I know the people around here for ages. You guys love the ship. Let me get off that cinematic mode. It looks good. Look at this. Look how beautiful you can make things look. Like, wow. This guy moves his mouse so darn smoothly. That I do, but not all the time. So that's why I have to have that cinematic mode. So I want to take you guys on a little bit of a tour of this ship by the name of the HMS Wurz in all her glory. Now, I thought, well, a lot of people love it. As I say, the most beloved build, and I can see why. The build measures, I think, 80 blocks long. In total, for the ship, by the way, these are the cabins for the crew. I'll show you a few more of them. All of them completely furnished. Super exciting. It measures, as I say, 80 blocks long. Not only that, it's also my most complete build. It takes the cake for all-time number ones of Jansey. Most completed build? I dare say it probably is. I haven't forgotten to do interiors. I never forget. I just never do them. And not only that, it also matches up in so many ways with scale. Like, look at this. This darn sheep is like, just put me out of my misery. I don't want to see it. Even you. Even that guy. They're just not interested in this. They're a bit camera shy. What can I tell you? I normally come down here and everyone's having a great time. Around here is also the galley because, wait, we're in creative right now. Don't worry, we're good. We're good. I didn't want to blow anything up on this tour, so we are in creative. Whew. That was my inner survival instinct kicked in there. I was actually panicking just a little bit, what can I tell you? I'm normally quite brave with these situations, but there it was, the Wurz or nothing. In fact, at least it wasn't a creeper. But the main takeaway, let me tell you, while I struggle to get through these, the main takeaway of this build is it looks good from up close, it looks good from afar. And not only that, it is probably the one thing that taught me shape matters so much in this game. And we're going to go ahead today and we're going to take that little idea of shape and we're going to move around this episode today trying to get the perfect shape for our ship. And I think I've got some good plans for it, I'll tell you that much. So while we're at it, let's head over to the new world. Just realized, a new world, isn't that like the reference to pretty much like America and Australia and everything being discovered? Pretty cool, considering it's all about ships today, and I just mistakenly made a little bit of a pun, I guess. But here we go. Look at that. Unintentional puns happening, hopefully at some point today as well. I'm sure there's going to be something along the line of a ship being incorrectly translated by Google Translate on this video, as does everything with my accent, apparently. Trust me, it's interesting if you ever watch it. It really can be. So here we go. Conveniently, some guy came into my world, planned at least about 42 blocks of length. I don't know who it was, but let's just go ahead and carry on with it. As for that, I'm going to give you guys some tips today, because there is a lot of questions out there saying, hey, Jansey, how do you build a ship? How did you get the HMS Wurz to work? And I'll tell you, there are, I'm going to put it down to one easy step. And that is planning. And I know it's like, well, this guy's just boring. He says planning. Who actually thinks it's planning? Listen, it is. I'll show you exactly how it is. And I'll show you exactly how simple planning can be and how fun planning can be. Because the whole idea of this is not planning in creative, not planning around there. It's about planning the length of the ship. And of course, I did do a bit of research. The first time I did the ship, I tried to get some proportions to make ships work. And I discovered something. And that was the fact that, by the way, we're just kind of going for an outline here. What I did discover in a weird kind of rule of thumb sort of way is that a lot of the ships tend to be a particular length. Let's say, split them up in thirds, right? The particular length of a ship. And then what happens is the first mast will go on the first third, and then the next two masts kind of spread across the next two thirds. That was a little thing I picked up on, for instance. So that's where the planning does come in. But the true planning I'm actually referring to is this stuff over here, which is just trying to get the outline right of the ship. Because to me, any build looks good from afar when you've got a good outline. I mean, it kind of makes sense, you know? It kind of makes sense that if you have it all looking pretty good from afar, it's going to look good from afar. Quite insightful, I'll tell you that much. Quite ahead of my time, what can I say? What we're looking for here is any shape that looks sort of shiply, and it does look a little bit like a ship, if you ask me. That's what we're going to do. We're going to keep referring back, running back there, referring back here, running back there. Listen, I've actually got a little bit of a story here, because running out into the ocean like I am right now, how many blocks is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's double it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is where my story starts. So going out into the ocean here can be a very dangerous place, because we do know about the very rare drowns that are never around when you're actually prepared for them, and that is the fact of the trident drowns. I'm always ready for one. I'm always down with my Smite 5. Look at this shiny. Oh, that's not Smite 5. Oops. It turns out I'm not prepared. I thought I was prepared all the time. I always feel like I've got a Smite 5 axe. No wonder I don't hit them for like 2 hits or whatever it is. But either way, what I'm saying is, the ocean is a dangerous place now, and I love it. This is what this game needs more. Not silly danger, but danger nonetheless in the ocean, in the air. Man, phantoms could be so much more than they are. But what I'm saying is, we do need to go ahead and protect ourselves from drowns, because it's bound to happen. Us swimming out here, getting attacked by a trident drowned, and having to move 50 blocks in the water. It's absolutely horrible, as I'm sure you could imagine. But what happened was, I was here, just swimming, minding my own business, trying to place a little bit of glazed terracotta. And I guess it really serves me right, because no one actually builds with glazed terracotta. The stuff is hideous. Although, I think we might find a spot for it. So I will be pretty much immediately going against what I say in some time, I'm sure. Now, let's just have a look at that. Take that in while we talk about this. So I look, I'm like, well, there's a drowned. That looks pretty darn cool. And then I look again, and there's another drowned. And then they, first of all, smack me up. One hits the other one. Bam. You know how it is. I die. And, well, we're here. But either way, moral of the story, don't go into the ocean wearing nothing but boots and a hat. It doesn't really work too well. And I mean, I don't even know what we would need. But fire protection and blast protection certainly are not the protections for drowned protecting. So there we go. We've worked out one thing this episode, if we've worked anything out at least. So here we go. This is the start of it. As you can tell, it's very raw, very rough. But when you're trying to build a ship like this, this is a little bit of a bit of advice. As I say, this is the getting real. Is looking from afar is always a very helpful thing, because 9 times out of 10, you're not right next to the build, and you're going to be looking at it from a distance, and you want to have something that looks good from a distance and looks good up close. But I like to emphasize the distance. Like, look at this, right? So you can see the trees, the palm trees, the birch forest in the background. Ignore that hideous tree. The buildings, it all looks good from afar. And to me, this is where the game, or at least building in the game, really, it sits very well at this distance for me. And here we are back with another time lapse. I really enjoy doing these, I must admit. I love just seeing the world come together. In fact, there were a few sneak previews of this one in the last few clips. If you look in the background, you can see these trees piling up there. Looks so darn cool. I mean, imagine when we've got so many more of these things all over the place. It's gonna start looking, I don't even know. It's gonna look amazing. Either way, it's gonna look so darn good. So while we're here, I also thought, you know what? I haven't actually seen this question, but I know I'm gonna get it sometime soon. And I thought, well, I'll put your minds at rest. Jansey, you know the replay mod is a thing. Yes, I know. I love that thing, but not for this version of Minecraft. So that is the one that I know I'm going to see. The other one is, how is the sun not going down? Well, good question. And this is one that I had decided on because I thought this was a pretty good idea, I think, for the quality of a video. Because I've been thinking recently, as I say, I want to improve the quality of my videos in every respect that I can, and it's kind of hard to reflect upon yourself and still notice what is something that can be improved on. And there's also a whole, like, there's literally infinite amount of things you can always improve on, which is just something about there. But here was something I noticed about my time lapses from previous videos. Not that I do many of them, but time lapses I've done, time lapses that I've seen other people do, and the whole slowing down of the time lapse to go sleep all the time, seeing the sun go up and down, I don't mind looking at that, but it does, when you go very fast, look very, very stupid when you speed the clip up a ridiculous amount. So I thought what would be a good idea is, instead of letting the sun go up and down, you guys all know I know how to sleep in a bed in Minecraft. If not, I guess that I'm probably just terrible at the game. But really, it's just a matter of me putting a bed at the bottom, leaving an ugly bed sitting around there. So I thought, you know what, I'll just do it for those segments. And then when I play the game outside of a time lapse, I'll play it normally. And that's what I've been doing. And honestly, I think it's led to a cooler looking clip. Even though it looks like I've built everything I've ever needed to build in Minecraft within a single Minecraft day of roughly 10 minutes, it's not the case. But of course, that is something I know that I'm definitely going to get, and I know some people will be all upset and could never imagine that someone dare do that, but yes, I did. And I think it is for the betterment of the video. So, of course, that's part of my grand quest to get it done. I'm now going to also go ahead and carry on, because I haven't completed all of this. You can see grass and everything coming over the edge. I really loved that. I thought it wasn't looking very good from the start, and then I got it to work, and I don't know how. Let's just roll with it. We won't ask any questions. We'll just leave it there. But just in general, the part over there in the distance of this build, we're going to keep going with forest. And I want to merge the birch forest back into some other sort of forest, probably in 30 blocks or 50 blocks time of building that. But you know what? This is like a little side project that we're finding all these cool things in. I am loving it. And I hope that this sort of stuff does end up doing pretty well, because I love just seeing the world come together. It's hard to put in any interesting building tips on it once you've seen them all. Once you've seen one, you've seen them all. So I thought this is a good little way to see it. I love it. I love time lapses. I love seeing things go up really quickly. Oh my gosh, there is so much here to show you. It looks very simple, but I'll tell you, I've done a lot in here. Breaking things, replacing them. Actually, wait, I'm forgetting something very important. The boat that I've created 5 million times. I'm pretty sure I've probably got boats left everywhere at the other base over here. I keep making them, parking them somewhere weird, and then losing them, of course. In fact, you know what? I want to show you something here. It's very cool. Well, remember what I was saying a bit earlier when I said, you know, there was a thing about thirds and masts and boat length. I'll explain it now because it kind of makes a little bit more sense, even though I think I have got these just off of being on the third. So let's picture this. Break this up into three parts of a boat. Right, first part there, middle part, and then end part. That part there is when part one and two kind of meet, and then the other two share between those. So versus having another one in there at the end of that third, they share those. That's what I was talking about. I know it seemed kind of vague and probably completely irrelevant to anything. It was relevant, but yes, it was vague as well. So what I want to do is I want to actually put these masts up. And we're going to put them almost, I guess really, we could go the length of the boat, which is 40 blocks. We've already done, we'll call that four. We'll go up here. So in this one here, let's do this. Simple way to count, all right? This is something I really need to do more often. So we just go up there. Who needs to count your blocks when you got the right amount of blocks in there? Easy. You see, it's efficiency in building. And that's definitely not my name in my game, but it definitely is a cool little trick. So you just go up there, you can talk about absolute nonsense, and by the time you're at the top, you've saved yourself valuable counting words over there. So yeah, that's what happens. I'm also going to do this, just crown it at the top. I hope it's the right height. In fact, if it's not the right height, it's going to be a bit of a pain in the butt. We're going to... Oh. Unexpected views right here. That is looking quite marvelous, if you ask me. Look at it. Like the little sewer in there, it looks perfect. That's one of my favorite little shapes we got right. But look at that, the paths and everything. So good. We do need to work out that over there though. Look at those spruce leaves. They kind of, a little bit odd, a little bit out. It's because we're using the Jersey Boy Better Leaves texture pack with the Jansey twist on it, because, hey, it's a beautiful texture pack, and I wanted to make it fit in with my birch trees, but those leaves are a little bit darker. I can tell you that for sure. They definitely did not stick out quite that much in the normal texture pack. Now, where is this? You there. Perfect. And because we can jump up on that edge, we can jump up there, and then, bam, we easy. Now here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we'll call it 6. We'll go check what that looks like from there. In fact, I could totally do a mega pearl right here, but then I've got to come back to get these. Okay, make sure we don't fall. All right, well, we got water. Who cares? We're all right. All right, so the moment of truth. Oh, that was stupid. All right, let's try that again. We gotta go for the moment of truth and actually be able to see what's going on. That might be a valuable thing to have. Also, probably not dying after, you know what? After I did so well in the beginning of the series to not die. Although I didn't have ender pearls and I was way more involved in thinking about what I'm doing. That looks a little bit too tall, if you ask me. Let's just step back so we get the full ship in here. Maybe we go from a bit of an angle. The broken parrots. Yeah, that's just a little too tall. Maybe what we'll do, let's just put the other two in, because there's going to be one over there. If we put in the other one, it'll go bam, bam, around that height, that height. We might actually have something here. So, you know what? Let's not cut it down just yet. We'll put the other two in. They're going to be slightly shorter. We'll see what that looks like. And I've actually got a very cool plan. If you have a look, these blocks of coal, those things look really good. Tested in creative. I can put my creative seal of approval on that for what we're going to be doing. All right, only one enderpearl death down on this ship. I think that is doing very well. Now, I'll tell you, I did take them down. They were way too tall. So I pulled them down a few blocks, I think 5, if I am correct. So yeah, that was well off. Because consider that, right? That thing's what, 30, 40 blocks? We did count it 40 blocks. That's a solid chunk of that to have taken away. So I was well and truly wrong on that. But now is the moment that I've been waiting for, at least. And I think this is what's going to make this ship today. It's going to crown it in a weird way, actually, quite literally crown it with the thing being on the top. And that is putting the flags on this thing. There is some controversy on whether the flags on the ship should fly facing forward or facing back. Now, apparently, and this is what I've got, they should be forward to the ship if the ship is going forward because the wind's blowing forward. But then I thought, but the ship's moving forward, don't they blow backwards? And then that's the big controversy. You tell me. I don't know what it is, but I can tell you what I've seen a lot, and that is that they blow forward. So I'm going to go with that. It seems like a lot more people are with me on the whole they blow forward thing. So yeah, we're going to do that right now. And what I've done is I've gone ahead in creative, of course. Oh no, okay, wait, we're good. Whew. It's like, oh, I just bragged about not dying again. Oh man, I'm horrible at this not falling off things thing. But what I was about to say is that, yes, I went into creative and I worked out a cool design for this. So I'm going to have to go reference my creative world real quickly and tell you what, because flags can be a real pain in the butt, because I don't want to just do a straight flag. I'm going to be going down and up. So it's going to be kind of slanting down and going up again. And that is a bit of a pain in the butt. So I'm going to have to put in a few little scaffolding blocks to get me there, which is a bit of a pain in the butt. And also we're gonna have to sleep, of course. Very good decision to hop back to my creative world and check it out, because I was so wrong in what I thought that this thing was gonna look like. Sometimes I just feel like, hey, how about we just wing it? We know what we're doing. No, I certainly did not. Now, by the way, this flag is a little bit different to the flags I've done in the past. Oh, that was dangerous, but we live on the edge. And what I was saying is it's a very different flag to the way I normally do flags. Normally they're a bit smaller than this, but I did play around in creative because I wanted to make the flags look a little bit more interesting than what they are. And this is what we've got. So take it as it is. I can pick out one thing I'm not a big fan of right now, but I think this over here, this shape, this little bit of a flare in it, it just looks so good to me compared to the ones, if you have a look a bit earlier in the episode with the HMS Wurz, my oldest ship, that one, well, had a lot smaller flags. They were probably, I think, 5 blocks long, so around that length out there, I think, from the flag post. So this goes out here. Think of this one and then this one. I'm thinking I'm liking them, but not only that, of course, it's a pirate ship, so black flags, of course. And also, of course, the big sails still have to come in, and the whole ship has to come in. So who knows what this is going to actually look like. I must admit, I've pretty much just planned this out here. The flags are the only thing I've done, so I've got no idea how this is going to turn out. But I thought it's worth the while of just going through the process of, you know, see how I do it. And then, of course, people who want to build ships of their own can go for it. But as I say, if you're not happy with the shape, don't go ahead with it until you've got that 100% right. And I think that's what we've got to maybe do a few more things with perhaps this edge here. But besides that, I think we've got the ship planned out. Now we just fill everything in. Oh, oh, hey, yeah, I'm going to need that back. Sorry about that. Yeah, you can just hang around with your buddy around there. And there they are. Look at them in all their glory. As you can see, I've done a few little changes, but hey, I'm pretty happy with the way these things are looking. I really am. I think the most important part here is that they look like they are waving in the wind, and there looks like there is a lot of wind. In fact, you birds, just keep your mob sounds to yourself. If there is something I would love, is the ability to speed the clouds up. It would just make it feel like them moving across there would look like the wind was going through. I don't know, just a little thing from me. Useless little things that I think of. But either way, I am very, very happy with the way that this ship is looking. And I hope that you guys have at least taken something away building a ship, or at bare minimum, enjoy the episode. That will be us for today, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I will be back very, very soon for part 2 of this beautiful ship build. And I'll see you guys then.